Apple's done it again. The tech world is buzzing over its latest gadget. But does the iPad really live up to all the hype we've heard for months? On the Consumer Watch, Sue Kwan shows us what the device can and cannot do. Sue?
Well, and take a look at all this. I have a laptop, my iPod full of all my music, I have my calendar here, and a book that I'm reading. And you know what? Basically, what the device does is cram all of this and put it in one place, into technology that the CEO, Steve Jobs, says is way better than a cheap netbook.
We call it the iPad. And it's so much more capable than a smartphone with this gorgeous large display.
Apple CEO Steve Jobs, in signature black turtleneck, demonstrates how he uses the new Apple iPad to read a newspaper, share photos, view movies, and read books.
Amazon's done a great job of pioneering this functionality with their Kindle. And we're going to stand on their shoulders and go a bit further.
And the iPad will also run current iPhone apps. So how much will this set you back?
Not at $999, but at just $499.
For that, you get a device a lot like an iPod Touch that is a half inch thick, weighs about as much as a dinner plate, 1.5 pounds, and sports a 9.7-inch touchscreen, 10-hour battery life, and built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. The iPad starts at $499 for the 16-gigabyte version and runs $100 more per upgrade. For the 3G versions, which give you access to the internet anywhere, add another $130.
I think it's really innovative. It's new. It's nothing we've seen before. But is it compelling enough for me to say I want to buy it now, even at an entry-level $499 price? I'm saying no right now.
CNET's Brian Tung says what bothers him is not knowing how the device will really perform because it uses AT&T's 3G network, which he says is already bogged down with iPhone users.
We have an unlimited plan for just $29.99.
Even with special low pricing at $15 and $30 a month, he believes many consumers will wait and see how the iPad works and what new features developers come up with.
Much like whole industries have been created around the iPhone and the iPod, the iPad will bring lots of money-making opportunities for people who create applications, media content, and books.
Developers can start building them now. The iPad will be available in late March.
And we think we got the goods. We think we've done it.
Sue Kwan, CBS 5 Consumer Watch.
Now, the 3G version won't be out for another 3 months. That's in late April. Alan?
I think I have the original iPhone. All right.